Tenemos una sorpresa el día de hoy. Vamos a hacer un delicioso pan de miel.
Hello everyone. Today we are going to make honey wheat bread.
Estos son nuestros ingredientes para hacer nuestro pan de miel.
These are the ingredients that you will need to make your honey wheat bread.
Una cuchara de sal.
One teaspoon of salt.
Mantequilla.
1/8 cup of butter, which is half of this 1/4 cup. We'll cut that in half.
Miel.
1/8 cup of honey.
Un paquete de levadura.
1 yeast packet. So you can get either kind. There's lots of different kinds as long as it says yeast.
2 tazas completas de harina de trigo.
2 cups of whole wheat flour. Whole wheat, that makes it a little bit more healthy.
Una taza de agua caliente.
1 cup of hot water.
Primero, vamos a utilizar la levadura y la vamos a colocar en nuestro plato con agua caliente. Caliente.
First, what we're going to do is add the yeast, 1 full packet of yeast. So we're just going to cut it off, pour it in. There's the whole packet. And then we're going to add 1 cup of hot water. Make sure it goes to 1 cup. And it's hot, but not too hot. Okay, be careful. This should be done with your pans, okay? You're gonna pour it in. And then you're gonna let it sit there for a while and let it start bubbling.
Nosotros estamos esperando para tener muchas más burbujas. Mientras tanto, vamos a medir nuestra mantequilla y la vamos a cortar en la parte de la mitad.
We are waiting to let the yeast bubble up some more. So meanwhile, we are going to measure our butter. We want 1/8 a cup of butter. So this whole thing is 1/4 a cup. So we're gonna cut it in half. And just use that part. So we're gonna hold on to that. And then we're also going to have our 1/8 cup of honey that we can get ready. So we're gonna look here. It's gonna be about right there.
Después, vamos a utilizar la mantequilla y la vamos a colocar y vamos a revolver.
Next, we are going to take our 1/8 of butter. We're going to dump it out into the yeast and water. And we're going to stir it up.
Más tarde, nosotros vamos a usar nuestra miel y la vamos a colocar en nuestro plato.
Afterwards, we're going to put in our 1/8 cup of honey into our mixing. So we already have our yeast, our hot water, we have our butter, and we're estimating about 1/8 a cup of honey. So that's probably about enough. If you have 1/8 a cup that you could use, I would measure it if I were you. That's good.
Luego, nosotros vamos a colocar nuestra harina en una taza.
Soon after, we put our whole wheat bread, whole wheat flour into a cup. We're going to add that in now, okay? So let's just do 1 cup at a time.
Y agregamos una cuchara de sal.
And we're going to add 1 teaspoon of salt and then finish up and add our last cup of flour.
Ahora revolvemos.
So now we have all of our ingredients inside. And so we are just stirring it together. As you can tell, it seems a little bit liquidy for this, for to make dough. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna add a little bit more flour to it, little at a time.
Si tiene mucha agua o es muy líquido, podemos agregar un poco más de harina para que quede más fuerte. Entonces le agregamos un poco más de harina y vamos a colocar un poco de aceite encima de nuestra mesa para poder tener listo nuestra masa.
Okay, so we added some more flour so that this can be a little bit more solid, so it's ready to come out. And we're going to first put some olive oil on the counter so that we can have a space for it to go so it's not going to stick. You take it out, and this is when you start kneading it.
Después, nosotros vamos a amasar. Esto es amasar. Y vamos a esperar por 10 minutos.
So then we are going to knead the dough for 10 minutes until it starts getting a thicker consistency. I might need to add a little bit more flour so it's not sticking so much.
Vamos a hacer una bola y lo vamos a colocar en nuestro plato y luego lo vamos a tapar con este plástico.
So next, we made a ball with all of our dough. We put it back in the bowl. We're going to cover it with cling wrap and we're going to leave it for 1 hour. And we're gonna see it rise up because the yeast makes it rise up. Leave it in a warm place for 1 hour.
Han pasado 30 minutos y nuestra masa ha crecido.
It's been a 1/2 hour and our dough has already risen and we're still gonna wait 1 more 1/2 hour.
Después de 1 hora, vamos a quitar el plástico y vamos a coger el pan y hacer diferentes bolas pequeñas.
So now that it's been in flour, we're gonna take a little bit of the flour out, and we're gonna take all the dough out, and we're going to now make different like balls or different buns that you can shape and have fun with making your own rolls.
Aquí hay algunos diferentes panes.
There's some different kind of rolls you could do. You can get creative, make things a little different. I'm going to do a braid here. I'm going to pinch them together at one side. I'm going to just braid it over the top. And then pinch it over the end. Lift it up and stick it on there.
Excellent. Después, tenemos nuestros panes en el plástico y vamos a colocar en nuestro horno 350 grados.
So now we have made all of our doughs in different ways. We made them into balls, we made it into a braid, and we covered it up again. We put it in a warm spot, and we're gonna leave it here for another hour. We put the temperature to 350 degrees Fahrenheit, and it's ready, getting warm. And in 1 hour, then we put in our rolls and bake them.
Al final, tenemos 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 y 6 deliciosos panes para comer.
Finally, we have our bread, our rolls. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rolls that we can enjoy. Please wait and let them cool off before you start eating them or tasting them. Wait.